Hello everyone, in this short video I want to analyze a malicious Excel document that I found on VirusTotal. As you can see, the detection rate for this malware is very low. Only one detection engine detected this file. And this malicious Excel document is part of a very well-known campaign. The malicious documents in this campaign download Z loader on the victim machine and running. So basically, let's first open the Excel file in Excel to see its appearance. As you can see, this file contains active content. Active content can be either VBA script or it can be macro. I checked before this file does not contain any VBA script, but you can also check it by going to developer and then Visual Basic, check each of the files, and it doesn't use a VBA stomping technique. However, we also cannot see any hidden macro sheet in this file. This malicious Excel document uses a technique which is using a very hidden macro sheet. A very hidden macro sheet cannot be unhidden using the Excel interface. You need to use a hex editor to edit the file and make it visible. Let's open the Excel document with a hex editor. I'm using Hexinator, but you can use any hex editor that you like. A macro sheet is a bound sheet. A bound sheet starts with this sequence 8500. Let's go here. As you can see, we have two sheets in this Excel document. The first one is called sheet 1 and the second one is called 0WC, etc. The 9th byte in the bound sheet determines whether the sheet is visible or is hidden or is very hidden. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 2 means that this bound sheet is very hidden. We want to make it visible, so we can change this byte to 0 and save the result. Now let's reopen the file in Excel. Okay, now we can see the macro sheet here. Okay, so basically the first cell that will be executed is pointed by auto open. Let's see which cell is the first one. So this is the first Excel macro cell. As you can see, the code, it's using formula. The formula has two arguments. The first argument is the concatenation of several cells, and the second one is Q4. Q4 is this one. Basically, formula copies the first argument to the second argument. So basically, after concatenating these cells, the result will be copied to this Q4 cell. Then the next macro is this one, then this one, this one. So basically we are concatenating columns and cells in one columns. And then, as you can see, same, 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 same. And at the end, it use workbook.hide. it hide this shit, so you cannot see it after this line will be executed. And then we go to Q4. Q4 was computed by the first column, right? So basically it execute the deobfuscated code of this column. How we can deobfuscate and see the actual code, the actual macro? We have two different approaches. One is not using Excel and just using a text editor and deobfuscate this one. Let's first try this one. So basically we can copy this column into a text editor. I'm using Notepad++. Okay, let's paste this one. Okay, before deobfuscating this column, we should note that we need to do this for 15 different columns. We have 15 columns, so we need to do it this 15 times. We want to use the very cool feature in Notepad++, which is basically creating a macro from the activities that we are doing. So basically we record everything and then replay the actions that we did on the new columns. To create a macro, just create on the start recording and then do the things that you do for decoding. So basically first we need to remove all the non macro lines. It seems that all of them are R7G in this file. So let's remove them. Then we need to change the ampersand to plus, which is the sign for the concatenation operator. Then we need to change char to chr, which is the function in Python for converting number to character, ASCII character. Then we need to remove all the equals. Then we need to remove the extra lines. We need to click on this one and then this one. And at the end we need to replace the new lines with the plus. Okay, now we have it. So let's stop the macro and now we have this one. Okay, so we have this command. We can just copy paste this one and use IDLE to decode this column. Okay, the first column is this one. Okay, let's go and check the second column. So basically we just remove this one, copy the new column, and then we can play back the macro that we built. Okay, we got this one. Let's remove this one, then go again to IDLE. So the second column is this one. Let's go a little bit further. Let's check this column J. Okay, again we can play back. interesting. We have column J. Let's go to column K. So basically we can see the usefulness of macro in Notepad++. It can make the analysis very less time consuming. We have extra 4 here. So it was extra. But that's okay. Okay, the second approach is to basically run the macro in a controlled way. So basically we don't want this line will be executed, because if it will be executed then we will not see the result. The second thing is that we don't want to actually execute the macro. So basically these two lines should not be executed. To prevent this, we can just terminate the macro here by changing this to halt, and then we can just click on the enable content button, see the results. Okay, now we have the deobfuscated code. Okay, now we can see the macro. At some point the macro will come and download from this file and this URL and dump it in this file, and then use shell execute to call DLL register server from this downloaded file, which is a DLL. Okay, that's it. I hope that you enjoyed this video as well.